What's up everyone? In this video I would like to share with you guys how you can make a kitchen. Of course you can make it out of scratch, just draw it from the ground up, but since I have been drawing a couple of kitchens, I made kitchen blocks, as I call them. So just basically all the cabinets and kitchen things you can have in a kitchen and make them blocks, so you can lay the kitchen out as you want. Very easy. It's hard to explain, I guess. So I'm just gonna show you. What I've done is those kitchen blocks I was talking about, I uploaded them to the 3D warehouse. I think normally, I'm pretty sure, you can just go to file and go to the 3D warehouse right here and say get models. But for some reason that doesn't work in my case. So yeah, I don't know what this is, but I can do shit with this. So I'm gonna close this, but I think that should work probably in most cases. But another option is just to go to the internet and go to 3dwarehouse.com, 3dwarehouse.sketchup.com it is actually, and you can search for kitchen blocks. I think I didn't try that actually. I searched for my nickname, which is Trevor229. Let's see what happens when I search for kitchen blocks. I don't know if there are more kitchen blocks around. I don't know. So yeah, it looks like I'm the only one basically, because I am Trevor229. So as you can see, this is what I made earlier. It's also kitchen blocks, so there you can see what I mean with that. But yesterday I improved these kitchen blocks, and I thought, you know what, I'm just gonna make a video about this. It's very very handy if you ask me. So this is the one I made yesterday. So it looks pretty much the same, but it's a little more detailed and nicer. And also you have two options for the doors of the cabinets. A more modern-ish look and a more classic look. So you can just download this. Let me just do that. And then you can see what type of SketchUp you are using. I'm using 2014 still, so I'm just gonna download this. So there we go. Then we can open this and you can say show in folder. This is Dutch, I guess. It's show in folder in English. And then you can right click and say cut. It's Dutch, it's knippen. And then you can go to SketchUp and you go to file, import, and then you go into the folder where you want the kitchen blocks to be, and you say paste, and now it's in there. Open. And there we go. So there are the kitchen blocks, and as you can see, you have these hovering doors here. Those are the more classic looks with these lines in them and the round knobs, and behind there, just on the cabinets, are the more modern ones with the long handles and stuff. So also I have two stoves, just a regular gas stove and an induction over here, so you can just delete the one you don't want, and same for the for these things. I don't know how you call them in English. And there the sink. I guess I also could have made a single sink thing, but didn't do that. And some wall cabinets. It's had some nice cups and plates and bowls in there. Some glasses. So I'm just gonna make a kitchen out of this. First you gotta determine, do I want the modern look or the more classic look. So let's go for the classic look, I think. It's a little bit more work, but I just want to go for the classic look. So I'm gonna delete the modern ones, and you can select the old ones and move them 500 millimeters back. I'm using millimeters, so it might be handy if you just, if you are used to inches and stuff, just delete those, select those. I guess you know the drill, but maybe some trick that you don't know, get it on the edge here. Get it moving on the right direction, which is on the green direction. Hold shift and just go to a reference point where you want it to lie on, which is this face, and click on it. Also, I see I didn't paint this over here, so let's do that. So I'm just gonna go do this real quick and come back when that's done. Now that I have that, I'm can start to put them in my building. So I'm just gonna maneuver it in there. I'm gonna select it by the corner. I press the K button to see it through the walls, so I can see the corner. Snap it in there. Press the K button again. So now actually this is already sort of the layout that I want, because I want to make an opening right here. Let's make that opening somewhere around here. There we go. So I guess that's the nice thing of this. You can just select this block here, move it, because I want this to be a little bit smaller. and then move this one over there, and it snaps right on there. And so this way you can just lay it out as you want. So I guess you get the point. So I'm just gonna do this now, and if I have the layout how I want, I will be back. Thank you. So now I am pretty happy with this layout. Now I'm going to give these textures some settings for Vray to give it some nice renders. So you're gonna select the material, then you're gonna go to the material editor for in Vray. You're gonna right click the material, create layer, and give it a reflection. I already did that, so then you get this window. Then you're gonna go to this M button here behind the reflection, and since this is, if you leave it, if you create the layer reflection and you don't do anything else, you just leave it at the default settings, reflection settings, then it has the gloss of glass. So if it's less glossy than glass, like this marble-ish material, then you should bring these values down. So I put these at, default is 1.55, and I got these at 1.35. You just gotta play around with that until you're happy with it. So do that, and also over here, the glossiness, if this is 1, and also this is 1, which is default, then you can see in the preview here that the glossiness is a little harsh. By putting this down, it's a little more fade away, if you know what I mean. So I had this at 0.88, but again, you just gotta play around until you're happy with this. But if you look closely, you can see it's less glossy, basically. And also, gonna give it some bump. So select the bump over here and press the M button behind it, and select text bitmap. And I have this texture over here in a folder, but if you don't, and you probably don't, so let's go back. If you have just downloaded this, you don't have the texture saved in some folder or anything. So you can select this and you go in the material window here and go to edit and hit this button over here. If you click that, then it will open in my case in Irfan view. So what you can do now is press Control G, and then you have a black and white image of the texture, and then you can press Shift G, and now you can adjust the contrast like so. And what you can do with these images or textures is you can put these in, you can manipulate the reflection with this also, and also the bump, which I will do in a minute, and also the reflection, just to show you what is white. If we are talking about reflection, everything what's white will get reflection, and what is dark or black gets no reflection at all. So if it's gray, it gets a little reflection, and white is full on reflection, depending on the settings you have put in. So if I make it like this, then it's all reflection, but the black spots get no reflection. So since this is marble, I just want a full on reflection, so reflection all around. So I'm not gonna do this to the reflection, but I am gonna put this into the bump, so then the white spots get bumped up a little, or at least it looks like that, and the darker spots get left alone. So what I'm gonna do is do that bump. text bitmap, and then you can select that black and white image. You can also just put in the colored image. It doesn't really matter that much. Only with the reflection, what I talked about, I will show you that in a minute. Then it does matter. So I got that here, the black and white. So let's see what we got. You can see it already is less shiny again by doing this. And I'm gonna make this 0.1. For some reason it snaps out of SketchUp when I'm doing this stuff. So now this is the sink. And this I want to be a little like stainless steel finish. So I already did that, as you can see. So for that I have increased the reflection value and these two values. I'm not really sure what this does. I know that this affects it way more. If you increase this a lot, then the shininess goes up a lot, and this does change something, but not that much. But it, I don't know really the details about that. So, and then the reflect value 2.6 and the highlight 2.8, and it does this again, very annoying. And now for the chrome pieces, now you can see this is way more chrome like and I did that by just increasing these values a lot and decrease these a little, just to give it a little bit of like it's not a mirror. Because if you leave that this at 1, let's just do that, it's just way too harsh. As you can see, it's just too much like a mirror, and it's nice too, but I like this better. And you can increase the subdivisions, which will increase the quality of the output, but it also very much slows the render down. So I only do that if you see it very well, or if these standards must be high or something. I'm not sure if I did these chairs. Those are also already done. Well, see, if you already did that in a model, and you download something in that model which has the same texture name, then it already has those settings automatically in there. So that's why all these things have the settings already done. It's I didn't do this just now. So this is another stainless steel finish, but this one I did different, because I believe, no, it's not a texture, but this one I have these both on 17, but it's not really as if there's a science behind this. I just played around with this and until I was happy with the results. So yeah, this is still at 1 and this at 0.85. God damn it, this is annoying. So for the cabinets, I have the reflection at 1.4, this at 0.95. Jesus Christ, this is annoying. It keeps doing this, this is worse than ever. And this is glass, so this should be 155. As you can see, that's default setting. Oh my god. Now for the wood, I don't think that is done yet. So let's do that. Let's just make a render right here. Let's do it over here so you can see it a little bit better. So I am gonna hide the kitchen and this, so it speeds things up a little bit. So to do that, what you can do is in the window layers, You can find that in the window drop down menu, layers, unit and entity info, layers here and the entity info here. So you can make a layer. I can call this kitchen. Just press the plus button and you can make a layer. Select the kitchen, go to entity info, and in the layer drop down menu you can select kitchen. So now this is in the layer kitchen and you can check that off, and it hides the kitchen, so that speeds up the model. And it's just sometimes easy if you don't want it to have in the way if you are drawing something. So this I'm gonna do in the layer inboedel, that's a Dutch word. So now I'm gonna make a test render of the floor. Also, if you are lost in the model, which can be happening quite often, if you are really lost, now I can get out really easy, but if you are really lost, Control Shift E and then you will get out of the model. So I'm gonna put a roof on here. Triple click, G, enter to make the component and get in here. So I'm gonna show you how to do the floor. So I'm gonna make a render first to see how it looks right now. So you can see this is pretty nice, but it's a little boring and plain and no reflection at all. So I'm gonna stop the render right here, because that's enough. And I'm gonna hit the teapot thing. I don't know why that's a teapot, but okay, whatever. And I'm gonna select an area here to see the difference. So I'm gonna select this wood. I'm gonna go to the material Vray box, and to start off I'm gonna create a layer and reflection, and this has to be a little less glossy than glass, so I'm gonna put this down to 1.2, and also the hardness of the reflection or the glossiness, I'm gonna put that to 0.75 and this to 0.75 also, and see how that looks. I think that's okay. And now for this, I do want the reflection. Well, first I'm gonna leave it at this, I think, to see what we have. I'm gonna make this a little smaller. So let's see. So now you can see that the light bounces off the wood nicely, but it's still a little too flat. So that's where the bump comes in. So check that, press the M button, go to text bitmap, and then you can just use the original texture image. A lot of people I've seen them do is also use a black and white image of it, but I don't see any difference if I do that, but it's probably some reason for it, but I just don't see it. I should have the hazelnut. God damn it. Where the hell is my hazelnut, man? Over here. Don't I have a gray scale up there? Oh yeah, over here. Yeah. So for the bump you don't need that. But maybe I will. I think it does, it should make a difference, but until now I didn't really see it. So I think one is a little bit too much, but let's see what we have. So yeah, as you can see, that's way too much. So I'm gonna bring that down. So you can see it's way too much. Bring that down to 0.1. I think that's good. Maybe that's not enough. So I'm gonna put this to 0.2, and then for the reflection, let it reflect not everywhere but just on certain spaces, like I talked about before, you can do the same with as with the bump, but then here with at the reflect M button over here, you can do the same thing, text bitmap, and then you need the black and white version of the texture, which I have over here. So like I said, the more white it is, the more reflection it gets. All the dark spots won't get will not get reflection, or at least not as much. If they are pitch black, then it will not get reflection. That's the theory, I know. So let's see what this does. It's a little hard to tell, I think, but so yeah, when I render this again, it did what it's supposed to do. As you can see on the right side, you can clearly see the effect. So this is actually a little I like this, but it's a little too much bump and also a little bit too much reflection. So I'm just gonna change that and see what happens. So this is nice, this is what I'm looking for. Maybe even a little less bump. I'm gonna do that real quick. Let's put the recorder on the side. Just 0.06. So, and now what I want to do also is here in the environment, because if you look at the shadows, they are a little bit harsh, a little bit sharp on the edges, if you know what I mean. So to change that, you can go to the environment in the Vray option editor, hit the M button on the top one, and let's see, increase the size over here of the sun. So if we make this something like 4, I think that's what I'm looking for. So let's see what that does to the shadows. So that's way too much. So let's change that to just 2. Okay, let's see if that's what we want. No, that's still not good, which makes me remember. Because if you have finally found the settings that you like, you can just save the complete setting package. I'm gonna make this 1.2 now, and I think that's gonna be it. But let's say you have all these settings over here working out for you for a particular model or whatever, you can save it just here as a visopt file, as I am doing way not enough. I have some here, but I should do this more often, because I'm always, for some reason, I'm paining myself over and over again to do the settings per model, basically. That is because it just depends on the model so much. How much windows do you have, and all that stuff. How the house is positioned, blah blah blah. But still, if you have a nice basic settings for example, for the inside, which I do have over here, for late at night and for daylight, it's very handy to save those things, which I should do more, but I guess I forget that shit, but whatever, it's a good thing to know. So let's see how the size of 1.2 does. Yes, with this I am happy. And now the last thing, because it is getting a little off topic, should be about the kitchen, but it's I think useful stuff. Obviously the background is very blue and bright. To quickly put something into the background, to have some green or a city or whatever, you can go to the Vray option editor and go to the environment again, but now the bottom one, go to the M button and go to text bitmap again. Then you should have something saved in a folder that is nice for background, like I have some examples over here. So you can just just hit something, open that. Okay, not okay yet, because you have to, at the bottom over here in the UVW section, the UVW type should be the second one, the gen environment, and then over here the mapping type is green. Then okay, and this will make, that's what I found out, it will make your render a little bit darker, actually a lot darker. So you have to therefore increase this value over here, I'm guessing like 8, and I'm just gonna render the whole picture now, and after that I'm just gonna keep doing some more of this stuff to make the materials on the doors over here, for example. But it's just more of the same stuff like I'm doing here. And also maybe make a little garden or something, just make some details. And I think I'm gonna leave it at that. I'm just gonna make some nice renders that I'm gonna show you after that. So if I'm not coming back, peace and cheers. Hope you liked this video, and if you did, like it.
weather's on the rise now. Woo! Endless celebrations all in my house. Yeah. Levitating now, I'm super duper fly now. Yeah. London boy, but they see where I reside now. Put the time in while you always yelling time out. And forget it, cause I know I'm coming with it. You were sitting, you were wishing I was handling my business. Yeah. Now I got the ball like Harry Potter playing Quidditch. And my business is humongous, you a thing that happens in there. Damn, man, I'm all bad, yeah, I'm all bad. Looking for that whip, yeah, that what you call that. Me where they at though. They at, I'm though. The new pop, all I do is rap though. Yeah. Want me on your song, throw a couple stacks, yo. Woo. Everybody wanna do the same thing. Yup, that's why we ain't on the same page. No. Do my own thing and I maintain. Woo. Flow like water, so I'm going mainstream. I'm going mainstream. Flow like water, so I'm going mainstream. Yeah, I'm going mainstream. Flow like water, so I'm going mainstream. I'm going mainstream. Mainstream. Flow like water, so I'm going mainstream. Yeah.